you can do to maximize the space you have. You've helped me in my home, and you just have an eye for it.
Help us all, Sandy. Help us all, not just Mary Beth. Help us all.
She can just help me. That's it. She's my personal person.
So where do we start here?
You know, most people say, I need more space.
Right.
And it's not a matter of needing more space. It's pretty finite. Okay. You know, if you have an apartment that's 700 square feet or a home that's 2,000, it's pretty finite. What there is, though, is unused space. And so we want to look at how to expand what we have by using products that are often around the home. So there's no need to really go out and load up on bins.
So many things we already have, just know how to use them. For example, what do we have in front of us?
Well, the first thing we're going to do is think outside the box.
Okay.
So what we see as its normal purpose, mm-hmm. we're going to have a different use for.
Okay.
For instance, the container you see that looks like a silver goblet, actually in its first life was a bud vase. I received some flowers in it, but now it serves on a vanity to hold makeup brushes.
And it's very attractive. And so now you don't have the full cabinets. If you're going into your cabinets and going, what could this be, right?
Exactly, exactly. And plus it can be a time saver. You're not foraging in drawers or in closets to find your makeup brushes.
Sandy, that does make it easier for a lot of people, I can imagine.
I love the towel rack.
That's actually a wine rack.
Seriously?
Seriously. So it can bring your towels out onto the counter, or it can go into a cubby so that you have it very accessible to your guest. Also, you could use it to have large bottles of shampoo and conditioner and other hair care products right at your fingertips.
Now, that makes a lot of sense. That really does.
Up and off the counter, though, for the most part. Okay, what's next?
Well, as we're talking about up and off, using a shoe bag over a door, which is up and over a door, to house things like mittens and gloves, or as I used it for our daughter, we corralled a lot of her Beanie Babies in it. We then advanced into the clothes and the accessories for the Barbie dolls.
Okay.
So it has more uses than just for the shoes, and because it's clear, you can see what's in it.
That's smart.
Now, for those who haven't used one of those before, are they pretty expensive or just...
No, they're sometimes under $10. You can get them a little bit more if you want to have canvas as the back, but the clear vinyl are usually under $10.
I like that.
Okay, and you have a bunch of doors in your house. You could have one on a lot of doors for different purposes. Okay.
Exactly.
What's next?
The other is a magazine holder in its usual life, but as you can see, it's got hair care products in it. So you could have the clutter come off of your countertop, slip into a cabinet, but extraction is very easy. Plus, it contains all those wild cords that seem to stick out when you try to pull it out of the cabinet.
Yes, that is brilliant. Could you also use something like that for some of the electronic cords and just electronics on your desk? Because you have the holes on the side, it could corral the cords, you know, going down into the...
Absolutely.
You taking that home?
I think I will, yes.
But okay, I'll go get one just like it. Okay, I like it. So use the space you have, like the up and over idea. You all have the back of a door. Mm-hmm. Think about what that $10 item could corral in this room, that room, that room, and think outside the box. I love it.
So we talked about up and over. What about down and under as well?
Exactly, down and under. The down is to compress. Often there are things in our closet that are out of season, so we can use space saver bags, and those are wonderful. They suck the air out, compress it down. Linens are another one. Usually people have more linens than they need, and once you can pare down, again, out of season or for guest areas that you don't use frequently, you can compress it, and then under things, like under the bed. And underbed bins are good for storing shoes or other things that you might not need on a day-to-day basis.
But you don't want to get rid of, because you will need them maybe when guests come in or whatever, or in the shoes when they come back in season.
Yes.
What does this do for you psychologically? Why will this improve our lives?
Because it helps us have things at our fingertips. That's about time, it's about peace, it's about being stress-free. And if we don't have to have clutter in our viewing, we can relax, we can feel like our lives are more peaceful.
Okay.
We don't feel overwhelmed anymore, because a lot of times, again, you walk home, you come through the door, it's like you're almost intimidated by what you have. But this way, Sandy, you make it so simple for us.
I love it. That's where you can find Sandy. There's her number. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I feel peaceful just thinking about it.
Do you?
I do.
That's good. We got to have you
but
back
then. I'll have to go home.
Tomorrow and the next day and the next day. Sandy, I think you got a job here with us.